What is generalized epilepsy and how we can make the diagnosis and treatment of generalized epilepsy? Well, generalized epilepsy is a condition when the electricity comes throughout the brain all of a sudden and fills up the brain, and the whole brain will be engaged with a seizure right from the beginning. The most common causes of generalized epilepsy is usually a genetic cause affecting the building of the brain. Well, when every cell, the channels and the receptors and the mechanism that control the seizure and electricity in the brain, and like I think of it as like the dials of electricity in the brain, will be affected, and that will cause more electricity in the brain and causes the generalized epilepsy. The symptoms of generalized epilepsy, usually a seizure that is generalized tonic-clonic seizure, shaking all over, starts from like tonic and then shakes all over, and also is will be absence seizures when the kid stops all of a sudden, will be look up, stops and pauses, eye rolls up and things like that. So all of those are signs of generalized epilepsy. It is important to know and recognize generalized epilepsy because the treatment can be completely different than the other type, which is focal epilepsy. One of the common causes of generalized epilepsy is generalized absence epilepsy and childhood absence epilepsy and juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. All of those are causes of generalized epilepsy that are likely genetic and usually starts earlier in life with kids. And some kids will have myoclonic jerks, like shaking all over like this. And this can be a sign of generalized epilepsy. The way to diagnose generalized epilepsy would be first to have a good history and physical exam and the description of the event. And if you have a video of the event, that would be super helpful for your doctor to analyze it. And usually it will be shaking all over from the beginning and those stirring spells that can be seizures. And then the second thing is an EEG. So EEG is a brainwave test. In generalized epilepsy, will show that there is a burst of electricity throughout the brain all of a sudden at once, and that can make the diagnosis of generalized epilepsy. And then the third thing is a brain MRI. Usually brain MRI is normal in generalized epilepsy. How can we treat generalized epilepsy? It is important to recognize generalized epilepsy because the treatment is completely different than focal epilepsy. In focal epilepsy, all anti-seizure medications can work, but in generalized epilepsy, that's not the case. Actually, even some seizure medications can worsen seizures and epilepsy in generalized epilepsy, such as the sodium channel blocker family, like Phenytoin, Carbamazepine, Tegretol. Those medications can even worsen the generalized epilepsy. And the medications that treat generalized epilepsy are specific for generalized epilepsy. They're called broad-spectrum anti-seizure medication that they cover all types of seizures. And specifically, ethosuximide controls the absent seizures only. And then the other medication that are broad-spectrum, such as valproic acid, levetiracetam, lacosamide, topiramate, zonisamide, perampanel, those medications can treat generalized epilepsy. Also, they can treat focal epilepsy. And to learn more about anti-seizure medications and all the different anti-seizure medications so that you can understand how they work and which is the one good for you, you can see this video for all the detailed anti-seizure medications. And stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.